everyone, and welcome to CounterBuzz. I'm Greg Rosink, and I'm here with Steve Hovland, product manager for rotors here at Hunter Industries. Now, today we're here to talk about pressure regulation and some of the products that are in that category. Can you give us some feedback or some information about the benefits of pressure regulation in an irrigation system?
Pressure regulation for us is very important because it ensures that the nozzles, whether they're spray nozzles, MP rotator nozzles, or rotor nozzles, are operating at the correct pressure. And there are several ways to ensure that the pressure is correct. In our little half-inch spray heads, we've got 30 and 40 PSI regulated product for spray nozzles and MP rotators. And for larger rotors, we've got a pressure regulator built into the base of the sprinkler, like in this I-20, and we also have it in PGP Ultra. Just as a demonstration, I've got a clear cutaway here of the pressure regulator in the base of the unit. So, in order to expand upon the pressure regulated idea, many customers have asked us for an under the sprinkler pressure regulator. So if you have a project with currently installed 3/4 inch inlet rotors, and you've noticed that that pressure is far, far too high, you can simply unscrew that sprinkler, screw on this underhead pressure regulator, and it will take pressures up to 100 PSI and knock them down to 45 PSI. And that's typically what nozzles are designed to operate most efficiently at. Certainly something far lower than 60 or 70 or 80. So this will take all those high pressures down to 45 PSI.
Can you give us some benefits of rotors and the different options that you have available for pressure regulation?
So for the rotors in the I-20, starting at the very top, the 6-inch stainless rotor is available with pressure regulation, and it too takes the pressure down to 45 PSI. All of those rotors are identified with the blue ring on the top. And then as we step down through the line, we've got 4-inch plastic, 4-inch stainless, as well as a PGP Ultra in a pressure regulated version, all that have this in the base of the sprinkler. But many customers have found that they don't want to change the entire sprinklers. They simply want to install a pressure regulator under the head, and that's the point of this. However, specifiers have found that it's much more convenient to specify a pressure regulated rotor right from the very, very beginning, and now you've got the benefit of the blue identification ring. And if you do it from the very beginning where the pressure regulator is in the bottom of the sprinkler, like in the clear version right here, then if someone changes later in the field to pull out the internal assembly and changes it to an updated one, you've got the benefit of still keeping the pressure regulator in the bottom of the sprinkler. So that's a handy feature to do it from the very beginning. But again, on the new PR-075 pressure regulated module, then you can go to the field and install this under the sprinkler. Now many guys are gonna say that, yeah, but if my sprinkler's already installed and I put this on and it's gonna raise the height of that sprinkler. I think that most times products over time tend to get a little bit too low in the turf and it doesn't allow the sprinkler to pop up tall enough when that riser hits the grass. So simply by unscrewing the rotor and installing this 1 1/4 inch taller male adapter, if you will, underneath the sprinkler, putting it back together, you get the benefit of a taller sprinkler that's now at the correct height in the lawn, and you've got the benefit of pressure regulation.
Yeah, and I came across that a lot when I was in the field too. Rotors get sunk over time. That's a great opportunity right there to pull the head up, add pressure regulation, because there's a good chance that if the system's been installed for quite some time, it doesn't have pressure regulation in the head. So if we were going to a distributor to buy this product, what would you tell a customer if they had a regular, non-regulated rotor in their hand versus the pressure regulated rotor in their hand, why they should buy it?
Well, if you've got a pressure regulated rotor in your hand, that's probably the best option. Then it's one piece altogether, no additional assembly required. But if you've got already heads in the field and you don't want to spend the money on an entirely new sprinkler, that's where the field installed under the head pressure regulator is the best choice. So what we've done here at Hunter is we've simply taken the same design that's been in the base of the sprinkler and we've modified it to put male threads on it, and now we've made that available as another part to the field.
Perfect. So coming back full circle, Hunter Industries, we're always looking for new ways to innovate and looking for ways to be efficient. And I think the pressure regulation adds quite a bit of efficiency to your system.
It does add efficiency because as you regulate the pressure, you limit the flow, the nozzles are doing the right job, and it's back to the book specs. It's not something higher. Many times when you look in the catalog charts stop at 40 or 50 PSI on the nozzle specs, but when we check the actual pressure, it's 70 or 80 PSI, and so the flow that we thought was 2 or 3 gallons a minute at 40 or 50 is now considerably higher when it gets to operating at 60, 70, or even 80 PSI.
Great. So now we're actually managing our water use and reducing our water use by bringing the rotor the proper optimal operating pressure, reducing those flows, and improving the efficiency of our systems.
I think that's the main topic because pressure regulation is so important. I would just urge everyone to look at the possibility of using a drain check valve in combination with pressure regulation. Those two factors can really save a lot of money. A drain check valve to prevent low head drainage, and then the pressure regulation allows the sprinkler to operate at the optimum pressure.
That's a fantastic point. So with that being said, thank you so much, Steve, for joining us
today. Thank you very much.
Really appreciate it, and we'll see you on the next Counterbuzz.